Here is 5 amazing masking effects that you can do inside of CapCut. The first one is selective color grading specific parts of your video. So let's say we're gonna darken the bottom area to give more focus on the subject. To do that, let's duplicate your clip. Bring down the curve so it's darker here. And we are going to mask. I select horizontal and mask the bottom area. Bring the feather to create smooth effect. Let's go ahead with curve again. Bring down quite a bit more so it's more darker here. And bring the highlights point up so the dark effect doesn't affect on the highlights. And I'm gonna add live effect in the middle, so let's duplicate once again. Bring up the curve so it's bright here. And use circle mask to brighten this area. Let's go back to curve. Bring down the shadow point so the live effect doesn't affect on the shadow. Then I'm going to darken upper area just like before. The second masking effect is reveal text. So let's create your text. And right click the text layer and create component clip. Select your clip and duplicate your clip by copy and paste or long press Alt on your keyboard and drag to the top layer. Go to remove background. Select auto removal to make selection on the human automatically. Now text is behind the subject. And we want the text to appear after the man crosses it. So select the text layer. And we are going to mask. And select horizontal. Then rotate to negative 90 degrees. We start mask before this man crossing the text. Add a keyframe on the position. Move a few frames. And move the mask as well. Repeat the same way so that the mask follows this man. Alright, we are stopped after all the text appears. Number 3 is shiny effect. Import your text, logo, or whatever you want. And right click, then create component clip. Duplicate your clip. And we are going to adjustment. Bring up the brightness and white so it's more bright here. Under video, we are going to mask. Select rectangle. Bring the feather up just a little bit. Let's rotate and extend the mask pretty much like this. Move to the upper left until it doesn't appear. So I'm gonna start from here. Set a keyframe on the position. Move a few frames. And move the mask as well to the bottom right until it doesn't appear. Then it's all automatically set another keyframe. I actually download this stock footage in this video from Artlist, and they are sponsoring this video, by the way. Artlist providing you with the highest quality digital assets for your videos. You can find any type of video on here. Just type in whatever you need, and there you go, beautiful nature videos. You can download as much of them as you want, and all of that in HD and 4K resolution. High quality music and sound effects are also accessible here. Find the right assets every time by AI powered search and filters on the left side. Then similar sounds feature to speed up your creative workflow a lot. Besides that, you can also find amazing time-saving templates and plugins. Anything you download with Artlist is royalty free, so no need to worry about copyright issues or anything like that. If you want to level up your projects, get the right plan for your needs. Do sign up for Artlist by click the link in the description below. Number 4 is Fog Effect. Import fog or gray image like this. Set it to full screen. Go to mask. You can choose either horizon to create fog effect on the upper area, or mirror and place this in the middle horizon. Make sure bring up the feather to create smooth effect. If there's human on your video, simply just duplicate your clip. Go to remove background and select auto removal to make selection on the human automatically. We can also do some adjustment to the fog so that it matches better with the background. The last effect is sky replacement. So let's import the sky image on the top of your clip. And we are going to mask and select horizontal. Bring the feather up to combine with the foreground gradually. As you can see, the northern lights is crossing the foreground. So set the blending mode to multiply. Now we can do some minor adjustment to your clip to match better with the sky. Anyway, this technique is going to work really well if your videos has a little camera movement or static footage. So, I hope you found this video useful in some way. Thank you so much for watching. If you did like this video, please give me a thumbs up. I will see you later in the next video.